Hello, my name is Miriam LaRussi, and I'm a student ambassador here in the Edward P. Fitts Department of Industrial and Systems Engineering here at NC State University. I know, a pretty long name, right? So how about we just call it ISE from here on out, okay? Good. I want to welcome you to our new Fitts-Woolard Hall. With the help of my fellow ambassadors, we will take you on a virtual tour of what makes NC State ISE and our Fitts-Woolard Hall so unique.
Hi, I'm Curtis, and I'm here to tell you a little bit about the history of how Fitts-Woolard Hall came to be. This building was funded through a unique private-public partnership, where half of the $150 million needed was provided by the North Carolina voters in a bond referendum passed in 2016. The remaining half was secured by NC State through philanthropy efforts funded by our generous alumni and friends. The building has been named to honor Edward P. Fitts, Jr., an ISE alumnus who graduated in 1961, and his wife, Deborah, and Edgar S. Woolard, Jr., another ISE alumnus who graduated in 1956, and his wife, Peggy.
Hi, my name is Nikki. Let's go ahead and start with the building itself. Engineers designed it with an engineering on display theme. That means that our laboratories are designed front and center so that you, our visitors, can see the vital work and research that's being conducted in this building. That includes advanced manufacturing, human systems, health systems, systems analysis and optimization, and supply chain and logistics. The building itself serves as a classroom. It captures real-time data such as energy consumption, water usage, and other metrics related to engineering.
Notice the exposed structure of the stairs. The sizes of the diagonal web members are not consistent. Instead, they vary in size based upon the magnitude of the shear force in the overall truss assembly. This exposed truss system enables professors and students to analyze the structure.
Hi, my name is Georgia. Check out the functional art. Instead of a flat, unremarkable wall, why not incorporate aesthetics and acoustic engineering to create a vertical sculpture with sound dampening qualities?
The angled, puzzle-like surfaces along both of Fitts-Woolard Hall's monumental stairs add texture and color from a distance. Practically, they bounce sound waves in multiple directions. Panel grooves intersect with drilled holes on the back. The combination absorbs and softens noise. The green roof system helps to manage water runoff, reduces indoor air temperature, improves the efficiency of mechanical equipment, insulates the building, and helps to manage greenhouse gas emissions. The depth of the lightweight soil helps the plants to develop healthy root systems.
Hi, my name is Leah Thomas. On the first floor, we have the first of its kind driving simulator in the US. It has 8 mounted screens on a moving platform that provides a 360-degree view for the driver. It also has all the features of a modern-day vehicle, including a steering wheel, gear shifts, and brakes.
It allows researchers in the ISE and civil engineering departments to observe safety-critical cases without putting people at risk. This driving simulator features future technology distraction, something seen in only a handful of labs worldwide. The system gives a realistic feeling for how quickly a driver could get distracted by various prompts.
Hello everyone, my name is Crystal Walker. We are in the Advanced Manufacturing Laboratory, which houses CAML, the Center for Additive Manufacturing and Logistics, as well as the Manufacturing Innovation Lab. CAML started in 2014. It was born from NC State's strong manufacturing tradition, a legacy that included a preeminent furniture manufacturing and management center and the groundbreaking rapid prototyping lab. In this lab, the 3D printing metal parts using the world's first commercial RCAM, AB electron beam melting machine, began in 2003. This lab allows researchers to test Industry 4.0, the emergence of data-driven manufacturing processes solutions. Each machine is streaming its data to a private cloud network for analysis and prediction. The research group also works with robots combined with vision and AI algorithms to enable humans and robots to work together in complex part fabrication and assembly tasks.
This is the tissue engineering lab. In this lab, they design and manufacture engineered tissues using biodegradable biomaterials. Basically, what that means is they're back in here 3D printing real-life human tissues. The team studies the relationships between 3D biofabrication processes, the biomaterials used in those processes, and the creation of scaffolds used to support those 3D printed tissues. Researchers will use this knowledge to develop new manufacturing processes and tissue-engineered medical products, primarily in orthopedics.
This is our human systems laboratory space. The labs consist of the virtual reality / augmented reality lab, the biomechanics lab, and the brain-computer interface and neuroergonomics lab. Using emerging technologies like virtual reality, body motion tracking, and EEG brain recordings, the research teams are pushing the boundaries of traditional industrial engineering. They are making workplaces safer and changing the ways paralyzed individuals will move and communicate in the future.
Each semester, ISC seniors work with local companies to solve real-world engineering problems. This lab is the hub where students come together to analyze their findings and to collaborate on their reports.
The semester-long projects culminate at Engineering Design Day, where all teams present their work to a panel of expert judges and winners are crowned.
Here we are at ISC's main office. This houses the department heads, business staff, and HR department, and students can come here to get answers to their financial questions.
These are the ISC Student Services. This is where an ISC student can come, meet with an advisor, and get many of their questions answered by the graduate and undergraduate coordinators.
The Computer and Visualization Lab offers a wide display of 270-degree field of view among six interconnected projectors for data analytics and CAD design, similar to that of the Visualization Lab in Hunt Library.
The room can host various events, including presentations of large-scale visualizations and simulations, interactive sessions for small groups, and immersive computing.
So there you have it. On behalf of everyone in the ISC department and my fellow ambassador, we hope you've enjoyed your virtual tour of ISC in the Fitts-Woolard Hall. If you're interested in becoming an ISC student or learning more about how you can become engaged with our department, be sure to visit our website, www.isc.ncsu.edu. We hope to see you soon.